Good Saturday morning and welcome to 217media.tv as we are live at McKinley Field in Champaign, Illinois, set for Big 12 conference play as the normal community Ironmen come into McKinley Field being hosted by your Champaign Central Maroons. The Maroons 14-1 coming into today's contest, 2-0 in the conference. They had a big win yesterday against the Danville Vikings here at McKinley Field. So Matt Brown at the plate. And he is recorded as the first out here for Normal Community. Addison Fugit, center fielder for the Ironmen, now up to the plate. And he takes a swing right there for strike one. And that one grounded foul down the first baseline. Schwartz on the mound today for the Maroons. We appreciate you tuning in on 217media.tv, streaming live and watching later on demand on our video on demand page, 217media.tv. Jason Liggett here with you at the ballpark. Set for a doubleheader here today. We're covering the first action. 1-2 the count. And that one just outside to even things up at 2-2. And that one, he got a hold of that one, goes into center field. Center fielder playing shallow and able to come up with that one. Alec Barger starting in center field for the Maroons comes up with that one. Schwartz gets that one in there for a strike. 0-1 the count, top of the first inning, two out here and we are scoreless. That one just to the outside of the plate and called for a ball. And fly it out of play, so 1-2. Remains count to Ryan Bowman. First baseman for the Normal Community Ironmen. And he grounds it to first. And an easy play, three up, three down to start things off for your Champaign Central Maroons. A strikeout followed by a fly out to center and a ground out to first base for Ryan Bowman. So three up, three down on the top half of the first inning there. And we're headed to the bottom of the first. Your Champaign Central Maroons coming up to the plate. For more information on Champaign Central Maroon Athletics, you can visit their website, maroonathletics.com. See team schedules and rosters. Follow your favorite Maroon athlete. That's athletics2000.com/CCHS, or the more easily remembered URL, maroonathletics.com. Also follow them on Twitter at maroonathletics. Be sure to venture over to Facebook as well and like our Facebook page. It's 217media.tv on Facebook. Search 217media TV, 217 Media Network. So second baseman Connor Mapes scheduled to start things off here for the Central Maroons as the leadoff man. Thank you. We'll take this opportunity to give a special shout out to Volo Broadband, providing technical assistance with the internet stream here today. That's Volo Broadband in Champaign. A big thank you to you. Max Armstrong on the mound. Aaron Armstrong on the mound for the Ironmen. So Mape steps into the batter's box. First hitter of the day. As the crowd continues to file in here at McKinley Field, a doubleheader today. We'll be covering the first game here. And he swings away at that one. Powerful cut there, 0-1 the count to Mapes. That one fouled back behind us. Looks like that might have cleared the park there, headed out into the road. Out on New Street here in Champaign, Illinois. That one low for ball one. So 1-2 the count to second baseman Connor Mapes. And the Maroons thus far this season have really been getting it done on both sides of the field, offensively and defensively. Scoring plenty of runs, get those bats going, and also some nice pitching performances so far for the Central Maroons this year. Mapes goes down swinging there for the first out of the inning.
Mapes is the first out of the inning. That brings in number six, center fielder, Alec Barger.
Alec Barger up to the plate now for the Maroons. He able to come up with a defensive play there in the top half of the first inning. That one low and inside for ball one. And that one drove deep, and that ball is out of here. And there is run number one, a big home run there out of the park for Alec Barger. So a nice rip there from Barger to get the Maroons on the scoreboard first as they lead 1-0 now. That one driven to right center field and out of the ballpark. DH Jake Snyder in now. Batting third for the Maroons. That one high and inside, 2-1 the count now for Snyder. And Snyder able to find a little bit of hole right there. Doesn't get it outside the infield, but finds the right spot between third and short. And he's aboard with a single.
Number 10, third baseman, Joe Isles.
So Iles up to the plate, batting cleanup for the Maroons. Iles, a third baseman for the Maroons. He fouls it back for strike number two. Oh, and two, the count to Iles. There's the pitch. And that one outside from Aaron Armstrong. So Iles aboard first, advances the runner to second base as well. Iles 1-2 count right there as he is hit and headed to first base. That'll bring up Luke Beasley. Beasley behind the plate for the Maroons today. He gets a hold of that one. Down the first base side, looks like it's going to land in foul territory. Oh, and 2 the count here to Beasley. Runners on first and second. The Maroons lead. And that one gets past the catcher. And the runners advance easily to second and third. So two runners in scoring position here as the Maroons lead 1-0 in the bottom of the first. Beasley took a swing at that one. He advances to first base, and the catcher throws to third to try to get that third base runner out. Third baseman not able to come up with that throw. And across the plate for the Champaign Central Maroons, number 24, Jake Snyder. So a single there for Luke Beasley. He took a swing at that one and just tipped it right in front of the plate. He headed to first, and the third base runner, Snyder, already started to take off, had to backtrack. Catcher threw to third, overthrew that ball maybe a little. Third baseman not able to come up with it, and Snyder ends up scoring for the second run of the ball game. First baseman Matt Brown up to the plate now. Yeah. And he grounds it in the hole between first and second base. He comes up with an RBI single. Looks like two runs are going to come across the plate there. As
Matt Brown singles into right field.
So Matt Brown with a single into right field. Two runs crossed there. And runners on the corners. So shortstop Nick Brunson up to the plate now for Champaign Central. That one high and outside, and plenty of support from the Champaign Central Maroon dugout, as we're going to see a meeting on the mound here for Normal Community. So they have a little chat about how they're going to approach this next batter, and we're back underway. The count 1-1. And he lines one into center field, shallow center, and finds that hole. Another run comes across the plate. So. So runners on first and second for Tanner Gordon here. Just one out in the inning, and it's 4-0. So 1-1 the count for Gordon as Central up 4-0. So a four-run first inning here for the Maroons. And that one outside. And Aaron Armstrong gets him swinging on that one. So strikeout there for Tanner Gordon. That's going to bring up John Foster, left fielder for the Maroons. And a throw down to second base, trying to get that base runner out, but he slides back safely to avoid the last out of the inning. Runner still on first and second here for Champaign Central. John Foster at the plate, 1-1 the count. Aaron Armstrong at the mound, and that one fouled back. Throw down to third, and that gets away from the third baseman. That throw just a little bit short, and another run comes across the plate here in the bottom of the first inning here for your Champaign Central Maroons. They're up 5-0 now. So Central bats not wasting any time, coming alive here in the first inning. They've got five across the plate. There's the pitch. Just a little low perhaps on that one, and it's a full count. That one fouled down the first baseline as Foster continues to stay alive here. Foster fouls another one, and look out. That went almost into the dugout of the Normal Community Ironmen. Hit that fence just below, protecting some knees down there. So we'll see if John Foster can straighten this one out. And that one scores another one. So a little bit of a wild pitch there from Armstrong. And coming across the plate is Nick Brunson. So John Foster gets the walk. Brunson comes in to score, and it's 6-0 here in the bottom of the first inning. And the Maroons have batted through the order. They're back to their leadoff man, Connor Mapes. Mapes with a strikeout first time round. That one fouled down first baseline, and it is out of play. He swings away at that one. I think he might have got a piece of that foul tip, hit off the catcher's helmet there, and 0-2 the count now to Connor Mapes. Connor Mapes. Runner on first. Two out. Bottom of the first. There's the pitch. Just low there. So I mentioned earlier this inning how the Champaign Central Maroons have had some great pitching this year and scored plenty of runs, and they've really showcased that here in the first inning. So Mapes goes down looking. Second strikeout there for Mapes of the game, but more importantly, the Champaign Central Maroons get six across the plate in the bottom of the first. So we're headed to the second inning now. The Maroons lead the Ironmen 6-0 here at McKinley Field. So Alec Trella leading off for the Ironmen, top of the second inning here. So three up, three down in the top of the first. We'll see if the Maroons can repeat it here in the top of the second as they lead 6-0. Three straight balls there from Schwartz. 3-0 the count. And that one, a little high, a little inside. Four straight balls. And reaching on a walk is Alec Trella. Jake Gillis up to the plate now for the Ironmen. The DHs this morning. Schwartz fires it in there for a first pitch strike. Runner on first, getting a sizable leadoff there. We'll see if Schwartz wants to throw it over at all and bring him back to the bag. Jake Gillins pops that one up and out of play. Two and two the count. Runner on first. No out. We'll see if the Ironmen can make up some of those runs they gave up in the first inning. Plenty of foul balls here today at the ballpark.
Makes me wish I would have parked somewhere else. And Gilhouse goes down on strikes there. Brings up third baseman Matt Nicholas. And there's Schwartz firing over to first base. Trying to hold Alec Trella to that bag. High and inside there. Foul tip there, back to the backstop. One and two, the count down to Nicholas. And Schwartz fires it in there and gets him looking for strike number three. So two down here in the top of the second inning. And coming up to the plate is J.D. Villafuerte. So Schwartz has recorded three strikeouts so far this morning. No hits given up. Did have a walk at the for the first batter of this inning. Villafuerte up to the plate now for the Ironmen. He takes a healthy chop at that one. 2-1 the count. Called strike right there to even up the count at two apiece. And a called strike three as Villafuerte goes down looking. So three straight strikeouts there from Schwartz to retire the side. The Ironmen leave one stranded on first base and don't get any across the plate. We're at 6-0. Champaign Central still with the lead as we head to the bottom half of the second inning here at McKinley Field. Jason Liggett here with you on a beautiful Saturday morning. Thanks so much for tuning in on 217media.tv, watching our video on demand. If you're interested in a DVD copy of this game, you can email us, 217media.tv@gmail.com. That's 217media.tv@gmail.com. You can also go online to our website, 217media.tv, fill out our contact form there, and we'll be happy to get you a DVD. Also, check out our homepage for a complete listing of the games we'll be covering this year here at McKinley Field. We're also set to cover the graduation ceremony for Champaign Central High School. That coming up on May 26th, 7 p.m. at Cranard Center over in Urbana. Of course, we'll be streaming it live through the NFHS network and IHSA.tv. You can certainly tune in there on 217media.tv.
Leading it off for the Maroons, number six, center fielder, home run hitter, Alec Barger.
So Alec Barger with a big hit to start the offense in the first inning. He had a home run over in right field. We'll see what Barger can come up with his second at-bat of the day. He gets a hold of that one, infield hit, and he runs it out. So a nice single there for Barger. Jake Snyder back up to the plate for the Maroons. He goes for a bunt, a nice bunt there down the third baseline. Not able to run it out, but he does advance the runner. So a sack bunt there for Jake Snyder as he advances Alec Barger to second base, and up to the plate now is Joe Iles. He was hit by the pitch in the first inning. Ended up coming across the plate to score a run for the Maroons. High and inside there to Joe Iles. That one fouled out of play down the first baseline. 1-1 the count here. One out, bottom of the second. Barger out there on second base for Central. Joe Iles gets a hold of that one. But right fielder for the Ironmen. Able to come up there. Hayden Stewart out there in right field. He comes up with that catch and records the second out of the inning. Luke Beasley back up to the plate. Singled during the first. Beasley calls time there. Takes a minute to step out of the box. And right back in there now for the Maroons. That one low, 2-0 now the count. Nice catch. Mike Shepard able to get a strike right there. So 3-1 the count. Beasley headed down to first base on a walk, so runners on first and second now. And coming up to the plate, Matt Brown. Pops that one up, and first baseman able to come up there with the pop out. So Matt Brown with a pop out there to first baseman. So after an explosive first inning, the Maroons scored 6 in the first. They leave 2 stranded there in the bottom of the second to score 6-0 as we're headed to the third inning. Here on the 217 Media Network. So a great day for baseball, and it's going to be a long day out here at McKinley Field, a doubleheader here. Champaign Central Maroons on top of things in the first game, 6-0 as we start the third inning. Coming up to the plate for the Ironmen, Hayden Stewart up to the plate. He looks at ball one right there. And swings away for strike one. And he lines that one up the middle of the field for the first hit of the day here for the Normal Community Ironmen.
Stowell hits it up the middle for a single. That brings in number 4, their catcher, Garrett McKenna.
Catcher Garrett McKenna coming up for his first at-bat of the day. And he gets a hold of that one. Looks like a pop out right there, and it is to left fielder.
Foster runs it down for the first out of the inning. We're back around to the top of the order.
So John Foster comes up with that catch over in left field. And back up to the leadoff man of this morning, Matt Brown, for the Ironmen. A powerful strike right there from Schwartz. That one a little low, so 1-1 the count. Runner on first, one out here in the top of the third. The Ironmen trying to get on the board. Brown swings away at that last one, so 1-2 now. And time called. Looks like Matt Brown might have caught something in the eye. And a hard chopper to third, tosses it over to first, gets the lead runner, but Brown puts on the wheels and gets safely to second. So a single there for Matt Brown, he advanced to second base. From the throw that got away from Champaign Central. But they did pick up the second out. So just one out away here from getting back to the plate. Addison Fugit. He had a nice rip in the first inning. Popped out to center. Oh, and 2 the count now to Fugit. Two out, runner on second. Central up, 6-0 in the top of the third inning. And they throw back to second. Trying to get Matt Brown, but Brown slides safely back to the bag. And a nice hit there from Addison Fugit, but an even nicer leaping catch there from second baseman for Champaign Central. So a nice grab there for Connor Mapes to end the inning. Normal Community Ironmen get their first hit of the day there in the top of the third. But they do leave a man stranded on second. No runs across the plate. We're now heading to the bottom of the third. 6-0. Champaign Central leads.
So shortstop Nick Brunson back up to the plate for the Champaign Central Maroons. Brunson with an RBI single back in the first inning, and he pops out. First pitch swinging there. He flies out to right fielder Hayden Stewart. Tanner Gordon back up to the plate for the Champaign Central Maroons. That one just outside, 1-1 the count now to Gordon. Gordon 0-1 on the day, struck out in the first as he sees strike number two right there. Aaron Armstrong started this game for the Ironmen, but now on the mound, coming in top of the second inning, was Mike Shepard. Shepard down, draws up a full count. Ball four right there. So John Foster back at the plate. Tanner Gordon draws the walk, so runner on first, one out. Bottom of the third inning from McKinley Field on the 217 Media Network, 217media.tv. Jason Liggett here with you. As Shepard gets that one just outside. Shepard tosses it back to first, holding Tanner Gordon over there. Gordon slides in safely. And they throw out Tanner Gordon as he got caught trying to steal second. So two outs now, bases clear for John Foster. Foster over in left field today, and that ball inside. Two and one the count. And that one fired right down the middle there. 2-2. Foster drew a walk in the first inning. This is second at bat of the day. He pops that one up. Looks like first baseman will have it. Playing first base today, Ryan Bowman. So no runners left on base there as Champaign Central Maroons pop out to end the inning there. They're headed
to the top of the fourth now. The Maroons 6-0. We saw plenty of offense there in the bottom of the first inning. The Maroons came out and looked incredible, highlighted by Alec Barger's out-of-the-park home run to get things started. We haven't seen much offense since. Normal Community, two hits on the day. Four strikeouts. So Ryan Bauman up at the plate, and he looks at strike one. Bauman chops that one foul down the first baseline into the Ironmen dugout. So 1-2 the count here to Ryan Bauman. Bauman grounded out to first to end the first inning. This is his second at bat of the day. So he fouled one off down the first baseline, fouled one off down the third baseline. We'll see if he can connect with this one. And goes down on that one. Looks at strike number three there. So one out as Alec Trella back up to the plate for the Ironmen. And Trella got a hold of that one. It is foul, just foul, down the third baseline there. Trella drew a walk in the second inning. This is his second at bat of the day here. And the count's 0-1. And a hard chopper there to shortstop. Alec Barger not able to come up with that one. Designated hitter Jake Dillhouse up to the mound. He's 0-1 on the day. And a nice liner right there into center field. That'll advance the runner, and runners on first and second now for the Ironmen. A single for Jake Gilhouse. So one out here, top of the fourth. Ironmen, two men on, first and second, up to the plate. Matt Nicklaus. Nicholas now. Takes ball one. Anybody at him go now? and a good rip right there, but hits it right to Connor Mapes at second base. Mapes sticks out his glove, comes up with the catch on that one. So two down here in the fourth inning. J.D. Villaforte up to the plate. Villaforte struck out to end the second inning. See if he has better luck here in the top of the fourth. Nice throw right there from Schwartz. Villaforte swings at that one, 0-2 the count, two out. Runners on first and second, top of the fourth. The Maroons ahead, 6-0. He pops that one high in the infield, over to shortstop. And Alec Barger able to come up with that one. So a fly out to Barger will end the inning there. So the Ironmen leave two stranded. Don't get any across the plate. And we're headed to the bottom of the fourth. Champaign Central Maroons back up at the plate. Still pitching for the Ironmen. Number 20, Mike Shepard. Shepard did not start this day. Aaron Armstrong was the starter. As I mentioned, a rough bottom of the first there for the Ironmen as the Maroons.
What position did you play?
Scored six there in the bottom of the first, and they still lead by 6-0 here as we enter the bottom of the fourth inning. Connor Mapes, 0-2 on the day, set to start things off here for the Champaign Central Maroons.
Come on, Central fans, it's rally time. Let's make some noise for second baseman Connor Mapes.
And Mapes swings on the first one. He gets a hold of that one, and that one falls in center field, and he's going to grab two there. So a leadoff double to start the fourth inning here for the Central Maroons. So Mapes 1-for-3 on the day now. Two strikeouts in the first inning and avenges both those with a nice hit there to center field. And he's on second base now, no out. So a runner in scoring position. And the way things have gone, even looking back to that first inning, it'll be hard for the Ironmen to hold off that run from scoring. That one fouled back once again. So 0-1 the count to Alec Barger. Barger playing center field this afternoon. And Barger looks like he hit that one off of his foot there. Shaking out the kinks there on his right foot. Coach coming to check, make sure everything's okay. As the count goes to 2-2. So Alec Barger grounds that one down the third baseline. And speeds down to first base there. And he gets the single. So a nice offensive day here so far for Alec Barger. He's 3-for-3. With a home run and two singles. He's out on first base now. No out. So runners at the corners. And up to the plate is designated hitter Jake Snyder. Snyder with a single in the first. Sack bunt to advance the runner in the second inning. He looks at a strike right there. And Snyder just a little bit behind that pitch, fouls it out of play down the third baseline. One and two to Jake Snyder. Runners at the corners. No out. Bottom of the fourth. The Maroons threatening to score once again. Runner goes. And they don't have much of a play there. As Mapes comes across the plate to make it 7-0. So Jake Snyder looked a little funny there. Might have a little bit of a limp or something there, even in the batter's box. But he does get the single, toughs it down to first base. And Spencer Hayes now running at first. And coming up to the plate is Joe Isles. Isles hit by a pitch in the first inning and popped out to right in the second. His third bat of the day. One and oh, the count here to Isles. Runners on first and second. Shepard throws it in there, and Isles gets a hold of that one. And he's going to grab two on this one at least. A run is scored. Looks like they're going to wave in another run. And there we go. Some nice base running there from the Champaign Central Maroons as two come across the plate. Make it a 9-0 ball game. An RBI triple there for Joe Isles. So the Central Bats coming alive once again here in the bottom of the fourth inning. They scored 6 runs in the bottom of the first and 3 so far here in the bottom of the fourth. And I don't think they're done yet. Beasley at the plate. He pops it up high. Should be caught there in right field, and it is. Runner tags up at third and comes across the plate. So one out, a sack fly for Beasley. And Joe Isles, who had the triple, comes across the plate to score, make it a 10-run ball game. Matt Brown, back of the plate. He popped up in the second. Brown lines, grounds it to short, puts on the wheels, but not quite quick enough as shortstop fires it over to first for the out. Nick Brunson playing shortstop today for the Maroons. One for two on the day, RBI single in the first, popped out to right field in the third inning. Overcast here most of this morning, but that sun starting to peek out behind the clouds. As Brunson falls behind, 0-2 in the count. He chops that one up the middle. And a tough play there for the shortstop and second baseman on the Ironmen. And Nick Brunson makes it safely to first for the single. Gordon with a strikeout and a walk. A big lead there for Nick Brunson. He dives back to the bag safely. So 4 runs come across the plate so far here in the bottom of the fourth, as it's 10-0, Central Maroons lead. That one low and inside. Catcher fires it over to first to bring Brunson back to the bag. So 3-0 the count here to Tanner Gordon. That one fired down the middle there from Mike Shepard. Tanner makes contact with that one, fouls it out of play down the third baseline. So a full count here, 2 out. Runner on first. And here's the pitch to Tanner Gordon. And he gets a hold of that one. That one driven deep into right field. He's going to pick up a ground rule double, it looked like. That one rolls out of the park here. And some luck there for the normal community Ironmen, because I am completely positive that Nick Brunson, who was on first base, made it to third would have easily come home had that ball not gone out of the park. So perhaps a little bit of a break there for the Ironmen. Runners on second and third now. Coming up to the plate, John Foster. Foster. Flied out in the third. That ball outside. Three and oh, the count to Foster. Runners on second and third, two out. Bottom of the fourth. There's the pitch and the strike. So 3-1 now as the Maroons still ahead 10-0. Was about to be 11-0 there, but a ground rule double. And that held Nick Brunson to third base where he remains right now. That one grounded to second base, and he's going to get the RBI single there. Second baseman tried to barehand that for the Ironmen. J.D. Villafuerte, he's not able to come up with that one, so Foster gets the RBI single there, and now an 11-0 ball game. Connor Mapes back up to the plate. 1-for-3 on the day at a double to lead off this inning. There's the pitch. Nips the outside corner there for strike one. Mape swings at that one for strike number two, so 0-2 the count. Runners at the corners. Mape would certainly like to hit the man on third home. See what he can come up with here. Shepard fires in there for strike number three. So Connor Mapes goes down swinging. The Maroons leave two stranded, but get five across the plate. So a big bottom of the fourth inning there for your Champaign Central Maroons. We're headed to the top of the fifth inning. Champaign Central leading Normal Community 11-0. So we appreciate you tuning in on 217media.tv. A couple more games that we have coming up this spring here at McKinley Field. This coming Thursday, April 23rd, we'll be back here as the Maroons host Bloomington. In fact, they'll play a couple of games this week. The first on the road at Bloomington on Tuesday, and then we'll be back with you on Thursday as the Maroons head back home to play the Bloomington Purple Raiders once again. We'll also be joining you on Saturday, May 16th for a doubleheader. Today is a doubleheader. We're just covering the first game of today's doubleheader. But on the 16th, we'll be covering both games against Peoria Notre Dame. Again, you can join us on 217media.tv.
number two, the right fielder, Hayden Stowe.
And Stewart back up to the plate and looks at strike number one. Stewart, one for one on the day, had a single in the first as he rips that one to left field in a diving play there from second baseman, shortstop, Nick Brunson. So a nice defensive play there from shortstop Nick Brunson and the Champaign Central Maroons. Garrett McKenna down 0-1 in the count here. Top of the fifth, one out. And that one down for ball one. And a nice rip there, a nice stop there from Connor Mapes, and Mapes fires it over to first, but not in time. Quite a defensive play there from Mapes. But Garrett McKenna had the wheels on. He's safe at first base. And Jackson Bronk coming in for the Ironmen as a pinch runner over there on first. Left fielder Matt Brown at the plate now. Brown fouls that one into the normal community dugout and falls behind 0-2. So normal community trying to get some runs here. They're held scoreless so far in the ball game. Certainly easy to highlight all the offensive play here from the Champaign Central Maroons as they scored 6 in the bottom of the first, 5 in the bottom of the fourth. It's now 11-0, but also look at that zero number. Some nice pitching here from Schwartz this afternoon. And he pops out right there. Matt Brown popping out to center field there.
That brings in number 3, Addison Fugit.
Fugit back up to the plate for the Ironmen. He's 0-2 on the day. Couple of pop outs, so he is making contact with the ball, just not hitting it in the right spot. He gets a chopper there to short. And Brunson not able to come up with that, so after Brunson made an incredible play on Hayden Stewart in the bottom of the fourth, not able to come up with that hard hit chopper to shortstop right there. And now runners on first and second for Normal Community. Brunson had that incredible play on Stewart earlier this inning. which was recorded as the first out. So runners on first and second here, and up to the plate, Ryan Bauman. Bauman 0 for 2 on the day. He grounded out in the first inning, and he does it again right there. So the Ironmen leave two stranded right there. And that will wrap things up here. As the Champaign Central Maroons win it 11-0. A total of 5 innings of play here at McKinley Field. We appreciate you tuning in on the 217 Media Network, 217media.tv. As I mentioned, if you'd ever like a DVD copy of these games, you can email us, 217media.tv@gmail.com. You can also fill out the contact form on our website, 217media.tv. So, plenty of hits, plenty of exciting offensive action, and some incredible pitching today from Schwartz as the Champaign Central Maroons get the first game of this doubleheader, 11-0. At McKinley Field. I'm Jason Liggett. Thanks so much for tuning in. We'll catch you next time. As I mentioned, our upcoming schedule here on 217media.tv. We'll have another game this coming Thursday, April 23rd. First pitch scheduled for 4:30 as your Champaign Central Maroons take on the Bloomington Purple Raiders. And then we'll see you again on May 16th, a Saturday. It's a doubleheader. We're going to try to cover both those games on that Saturday. May 16th against Peoria Notre Dame. So 11-0, the final of this game from McKinley Field. This is Jason Liggett. Thanks so much for tuning in on 217media.tv.